Hi everybody and welcome back to my channel and welcome to, I don't even know what to call this, I guess another channel update. I didn't think I would be doing these, one of these at least so soon, even though it's been at least a year or more since my last one. But I felt like I needed to do one because I've been gone for a little over a month and highly unintended. I always say that my breaks are usually unintended because they are, for to be honest. And usually when I'm not uploading for a while, it's usually at the most maybe a week or two, and then I'm usually back to uploading. But my unintended break turned into something bigger. But before I get into all of that, I'm gonna kind of tell you guys what you're gonna be seeing on the screen so you kind of know who you're looking at while I'm talking, while I've been gone. These are the Sims that I've kind of been playing while I've been away, at least when I could play. They are Sims that I kind of, one is, the one that you're seeing on screen is actually a Sim that I use story mode, which I a lot of times forget about that feature in the game. So I kind of wanted to start another challenge because I kind of like realized I really like playing those off screen. So when Cottage Living came out, DSims created a challenge called the Blooming Challenge or the Bloomingful Challenge. Hold on, let me make sure I call it the correct name because I've been playing. This is the only thing I've been playing for like months, not months, but the month I've been gone. It's called the Bloomingful Challenge. Yes, there we go. Correct name. And so I started playing it. So one sim is sim that I use story mode to create. And then the other sim, which you don't see at the current moment, who's sleeping, is a sim that I just made out of random, like a random sim that, you know, when they give you a random sim. And it's like one of the usual sims that kind of pop up when you get, when you go in to create a sim from the loading screen. And so I just kind of edited that person. Then the next sim I made was a story mode sim. But because now sims seem to, when you load into a game randomly, have ages, the story mode sim was older than the sim that I technically created first. But anyway, so I've been playing the Bloomingful Challenge. They're in the middle of winter, of course, because it's the Bloomingful Challenge. They live in Henford-on-Bagley. I'm doing pretty well. I just happen to be playing that, and I figured I might as well record me playing the challenge so that you guys can see what I've been doing, at least, because I haven't actually been playing any of my LP households. I've been trying to stay away from them because I fully intended to come back. Okay, so now into this. The reason why I've been away, because initially, you know, I was doing my kind of work getting in my way of me uploading, and I was like, okay, I'm gonna come back, you know, as soon as I can. Like when we had the spa day refresh, I was like, okay, I'm gonna come back around that time. But what happened was that my room that I, you know, my bedroom where I currently record my videos now, was getting its own little refresh, and I wanted to get videos out before my room got made over. But because of my work schedule getting a little bit more hectic, I wasn't able to get any videos out before my room went into its refresh stage. And so my computer was down for almost 2 weeks. So I didn't even get to play my game until way after the whole spa day refresh was out. So I kind of missed the whole initial, I guess, the initial rush of everything. I love the little trailer remake that they did and everything, but I didn't even get it to get into that. And so finally, when I got everything set back up and ready to go, I got sick, and bad sick. Like an old sick, old illness that I've had, haven't had to deal with in like years, flared up, and it flared up bad with a vengeance, and it sent me to have to get surgery. So because of the sudden surgery, that took me out for another couple more weeks. I had to heal. I actually tried to at least sit at my computer and like do a little video to be like, hey guys, I'm gonna be out for a while longer than intended, da da da. But I couldn't even sit in my chair long enough to even like properly even play my game. So my game didn't get played for another even with 2 more weeks. And then when I finally came back, I kind of just was trying to slowly work my way back into having the strength to sit at the computer long enough to record a video. So, and while I was doing that, I've been playing the Blueful Challenge, enjoying it a lot, kind of keeping me in the new pack while I was healing. And it's a pack that I love because I have three LPs that I have going on that I did not want to just cut off. The Michaels Rewind, I will most likely bring that back first because that's actually where I kind of left off in my, I guess, scheduling of how my LPs are uploaded. And I am winding that one off, so I kind of wanted to get that wounded off before we get any new packs. But I guess we're not getting any new expansion packs for this year, so I mean, I guess I don't have to rush on that. But I did want to wind that off because that LP has been going on for quite a while. As much as I love the Michaels, I love them. But I was kind of hoping that whatever expansion pack that we would probably get for the second half of the year would kind of refresh the LP a little bit more to send it off on a good note. But since we're not getting that, and I don't want to keep pushing off ending the LP because of that, so I'm going to have to just figure out what I need to figure out and get that going. Definitely gonna finish up my Not So Berry Generation Orange challenge. Love that little LP. Definitely want to complete that because I mean, we just got the next generation born too the last time I was there. And then I also want to definitely get back to my Cottage Living LP because, like I said, the Bloomfield challenge kind of helped me keep my love for the pack and remind me that I definitely want to give that LP the full justice that I wanted to give it when I initially started it. I had a storyline planned out and I want to complete that. So I definitely will be bringing back all of my LPs that were going on at the time of my sudden hiatus. But also, I kind of wanted to talk a little bit about the kits that we keep to getting. The kits that we're getting in the expansion pack that we're not getting. Like, initially, I was like, okay, whatever, kits, no big deal. We're still supposedly supposed to be getting, you know, I thought we were still supposed to be getting, you know, the usual amount of packs that we get throughout the year. The usual content and the kits will be thrown in here and there. But I feel like 2021 has been the year of kits. We got, what, one game pack and one expansion pack and how many kits this year? Like, supposedly a lot of Simmons were excited for the most recent, the most recent kit. I think it's called the Blooming Room kit. I don't know. Supposedly Simmers seem to be excited about it because they like plants. I am not a plant mom. I'm not excited about the kit. I probably will eventually get it because I'm one of those Simmers that like to have a complete collection. But also, I'm not going to rush to buy packs that I don't deem necessary at the current time. There are actually, like, this will probably maybe like the third or fourth kit that I have not bought. I've only bought a few. Like, I kind of bought the first three because I was like, oh, okay, and I didn't even buy them all at once just to kind of test out what it is. But now I'm just like, I'll pass. I'll get them when I feel like it. I think the only one that I bought while I was gone was the Inchon Arrivals kit. Just because, I mean, hello. I mean, one, if you're not new to my channel, you know I'm into K-pop and K-drama, so that even spoke to me anyway. But also, I'm more into the Greatest Sim kits in general anyway, because even though I do build every once in a while on my channel, I'm not a huge builder. I'm here for the gameplay kits, but we've only gotten one, and we've gotten a bunch of build kits. So the few Greatest Sim kits I've gotten, the only one I didn't get was the other one that we got when Inchon Arrivals came out, because I tend to not play Sims from that are Middle Eastern just because I like to stay true to the culture that I know, and I don't know much about the culture, so I tend to only play Sims if I have somewhat of an idea what the culture will be like, or Sims that will be, you know, and I like to be respectful. So I was like, I'll probably eventually get that kit because it is a creative Sim kit. But because I don't have any Sims that will be in dire need of any of the assets that are in that kit at the current moment, I said I'll get it whenever I feel like getting it. But yeah, I'm not too happy about one expansion pack and a bunch of kits throughout the year. I'm not even really too pressed about how many game packs or stuff packs we get. Like, for me, my main thrill of packs that come out per year, I'm always waiting for what was the next expansion pack going to be. And the mere fact that we're not getting one at the end of the year is really bothering me because I was tired of hearing the news about kits. And I thought we were going to get like, ooh, 2021 is going to make up for how 2020 went. And I didn't even want to like brush off 2020 because a lot happened and a lot of the community had to work from home. So, you know, I gave them that leeway and I thought, okay, so 2021 is going to work better for it because they kind of found their groove of having to work from home and how to get stuff out. Granted, cottage living was definitely a very well put together expansion pack, at least in my eyes. But also, I'm the first time playing a farming pack as well, so I don't know where to gauge on the level of how good a pack, at least for, but for me, I enjoy the pack. For someone who didn't really care for a farming pack to come out, I enjoyed it. So, I don't know if this is a good look for them to continue to keep pushing out so much kits, and I feel like the community feels that way too at this point now because we've gotten so many this year and no second expansion pack. Even though we all love cottage living, I feel like the general theme is that everyone loves cottage living, but where's our second expansion pack though? You're not giving what you're supposed to be giving. And so I'm just, hopefully 2022 will be better. Hopefully I won't be saying this at the end of 2022, but yeah, I'm a little disappointed, but I'm gonna try to enjoy my LPs and enjoy what I got and deal with it. But we also have gotten some good game updates, but there's some glitches that we didn't get fixed yet. So if we're not gonna get an expansion pack, I need some glitches fixed by the end of the year. That's all I'm saying. But yeah, that's it, guys. I'm gonna stop my rambling because this is really just supposed to be a general update just to kind of let you guys know where I've been. I will be back. I do have to take my time on getting stuff out. I can't push myself too much. So because I am back at work now, I used to be able to like still record after work on most days. Because I'm a little bit more exhausted because I'm still building my strength back up, I can't guarantee that I can get videos back out at a better pace than I was beforehand. I'm gonna try my best, but also I don't want to push myself. So guys, I hope that you understand and we'll be back for when I do get my LPs back going on my channel. I miss you guys and I appreciate any support that you throw my way. So if you enjoyed this little channel update, I guess I could say, just go ahead and leave your comments and suggestions down below. Hit that like button because you know you want to, subscribe if you haven't, and hit that bell button so you get notified every time I upload a video. And until when I return, guys, bye.